sperm is the male reproductive cell and is derived from the Greek word sperma. In the types of sexual reproduction known as anisogamy and its subtype oogamy, there is a marked difference in the size of the gametes, with the smaller one being termed the male or sperm cell. A uniflagellar sperm cell that is motile is referred to as a spermatozoon, whereas a non-motile sperm cell is referred to as a spermatium. Sperm cells cannot divide and have a limited lifespan, but after fusion with egg cells during fertilization, a new organism begins developing, starting as a totipotent zygote. The human sperm cell is haploid, so that its 23 chromosomes can join the 23 chromosomes of the female egg to form a diploid cell. In mammals, sperm develops in the testicles, stored in the epididymis, and is released from the penis. Sperm in animals. Function. The main sperm function is to reach the ovum and fuse with it to deliver two subcellular structures, the male pronucleus that contains the genetic material and the centrioles that are structures that help organize the microtubule cytoskeleton. Anatomy. The mammalian sperm cell consists of a head, neck, a midpiece, and a tail. The head contains the nucleus with densely coiled chromatin fibers, surrounded anteriorly by an acrosome, which contains enzymes used for penetrating the female egg. The neck contains the sperm centrioli. The midpiece has a central filamentous core with many mitochondria spiraled around it, used for ADP production for the journey through the female cervix, uterus, and uterine tubes. The tail or flagellum executes the lashing movements that propel the spermatocyte. During fertilization, the sperm provides three essential parts to the oocyte: a signaling or activating factor, which causes the metabolically dormant oocyte to activate, the haploid paternal genome, the centrioli, which is responsible for forming the centrosome and microtubule system. As the sperm arrive at the egg, it is the egg that chooses the sperm and pulls it towards her. The selected sperm actually tries to swim away from the egg but is tethered to the egg by female hormones. The membrane around the egg literally opens up and swallows the sperm. Although semen contains hundreds of millions of sperm, the egg will admit only one. The other ones will die within 3 to 5 days and are absorbed by the body. Origin. The spermatozoa of animals are produced through spermatogenesis inside the male gonads via meiotic division. The initial spermatozoon process takes around 70 days to complete. The sperm added stage is where the sperm develops the familiar tail. The next stage, where it becomes fully mature, takes around 60 days when it is called a spermatozoon. Sperm cells are carried out of the male body in a fluid known as semen. Human sperm cells can survive within the female reproductive tract for more than 5 days post-coitus. Semen is produced in the seminal vesicles, prostate gland, and urethral glands. In 2016, scientists at Nanjing Medical University claimed they had produced cells resembling mouse spermatids artificially from stem cells. They injected these spermatids into mouse eggs and produced pups. Sperm quality. Sperm quantity and quality are the main parameters in semen quality, which is a measure of the ability of semen to accomplish fertilization. Thus, in humans, it is a measure of fertility in a man. The genetic quality of sperm, as well as its volume and motility, all typically decrease with age. DNA damage is present in sperm cells in the period after meiosis but before fertilization may be repaired in the fertilized egg, but if not repaired, can have serious deleterious effects on fertility and the developing embryo. Human sperm cells are particularly vulnerable to free radical attack and the generation of oxidative DNA damage. The post-meiotic phase of mouse spermatogenesis is very sensitive to environmental genotoxic agents, because as male germ cells form mature sperm, they progressively lose the ability to repair DNA damage. Irradiation of male mice during late spermatogenesis can induce damage that persists for at least 7 days in the fertilizing sperm cells, and disruption of maternal DNA double-strand break repair pathways increases sperm cell-derived chromosomal aberrations. Treatment of male mice with melphalan, a bifunctional alkylating agent frequently employed in chemotherapy, induces DNA lesions during meiosis that may persist in an unrepaired state as germ cells progress through DNA repair-competent phases of spermatogenic development. Such unrepaired DNA damages in sperm cells, after fertilization, can lead to offspring with various abnormalities. Sperm size. Related to sperm quality is sperm size, at least in some animals. For instance, the sperm of some species of fruit fly are up to 5.8 centimeters long, about 20 times as long as the fly itself. Longer sperm cells are better than their shorter counterparts at displacing competitors from the female's seminal receptacle. The benefit to females is that only healthy males carry good genes that can produce long sperm in sufficient quantities to outcompete their competitors. Market for human sperm. Some sperm banks hold up to 170 liters of sperm. In addition to ejaculation, it is possible to extract sperm through teats. On the global market, Denmark has a well-developed system of human sperm export. This success mainly comes from the reputation of Danish sperm donors for being of high quality and, in contrast with the law in the other Nordic countries, gives donors the choice of being either anonymous or non-anonymous to the receiving couple. Furthermore, Nordic sperm donors tend to be tall and highly educated and have altruistic motives for their donations, partly due to the relatively low monetary compensation in Nordic countries. More than 50 countries worldwide are importers of Danish sperm, including Paraguay, Canada, Kenya, and Hong Kong. However, the Food and Drug Administration of the U.S. has banned import of any sperm, motivated by a risk of transmission of Creutzfeldt-Jakob disease, although such a risk is insignificant, since artificial insemination is very different from the route of transmission of Creutzfeldt-Jakob disease. The prevalence of Creutzfeldt-Jakob disease for donors is at most 1 in a million, and if the donor was a carrier, the infectious proteins would still have to cross the blood-testis barrier to make transmission possible. History. Sperm were first observed in 1677 by Antony van Leeuwenhoek using a microscope. He described them as being animalcules, probably due to his belief in preformationism, which thought that each sperm contained a fully formed but small human. Forensic analysis. Ejaculated fluids are detected by ultraviolet light, irrespective of the structure or color of the surface. Sperm heads, e.g. from vaginal swabs, are still detected by microscopy using the Christmas tree stain method, i.e., Kernig-Trott-Picro-Indigo-Carmine staining. Sperm in plants. Sperm cells in algal and many plant gametophytes are produced in male gametangia via mitotic division. In flowering plants, sperm nuclei are produced inside pollen. Motile sperm cells. Motile sperm cells typically move via flagella and require a water medium in order to swim toward the egg for fertilization. In animals, most of the energy for sperm motility is derived from the metabolism of fructose carried in the seminal fluid. This takes place in the mitochondria located in the sperm's midpiece. These cells cannot swim backwards due to the nature of their propulsion. The uniflagellated sperm cells of animals are referred to as spermatozoa, and are known to vary in size. Motile sperm are also produced by many protists and the gametophytes of bryophytes, ferns, and some gymnosperms such as cycads and ginkgo. The sperm cells are the only flagellated cells in the life cycle of these plants. In many ferns and lycophytes, they are multi-flagellated. In nematodes, the sperm cells are amoeboid and crawl, rather than swim, towards the egg cell. Non-motile sperm cells. Non-motile sperm cells called spermatia lack flagella and therefore cannot swim. Spermatia are produced in a spermatangium. Because spermatia cannot swim, they depend on their environment to carry them to the egg cell. Some red algae, such as polysiphonia, produce non-motile spermatia that are spread by water currents after their release. The spermatia of rust fungi are covered with a sticky substance. They are produced in flask-shaped structures containing nectar, which attract flies that transfer the spermatia to nearby hyphae for fertilization in a mechanism similar to insect pollination in flowering plants. Fungal spermatia may be confused with conidia. Conidia are spores that germinate independently of fertilization, whereas spermatia are gametes that are required for fertilization. In some fungi, such as Neurospora crassa, spermatia are identical to microconidia as they can perform both functions of fertilization as well as giving rise to new organisms without fertilization. Sperm nuclei. In almost all embryophytes, including most gymnosperms and all angiosperms, the male gametophytes are the primary mode of dispersal, for example via wind or insect pollination, eliminating the need for water to bridge the gap between male and female. Each pollen grain contains a spermatogenous cell. Once the pollen lands on the stigma of a receptive flower, it germinates and starts growing a pollen tube through the carpel. Before the tube reaches the ovule, the nucleus of the generative cell in the pollen grain divides and gives rise to two sperm nuclei, which are then discharged through the tube into the ovule for fertilization. In some protists, fertilization also involves sperm nuclei, rather than cells, migrating toward the egg cell through a fertilization tube. Oomycetes form sperm nuclei in a syncytical antheridium surrounding the egg cells. The sperm nuclei reach the eggs through fertilization tubes, similar to the pollen tube mechanism in plants. Sperm centrioles. Most sperm cells have centrioles in the sperm neck. Sperm of many animals has two centrioles known as the proximal centriole and distal centriole. Some animals like human have a single centriole known as the proximal centriole. Mice and rat have no sperm centrioles. The fruit fly Drosophila melanogaster has a single centriole and an atypical centriole named the proximal centriole-like. Sperm tail formation. The sperm tail is a specialized type of cilium. In many animals the sperm tail is formed in a unique way, which is named cytosolic ciliogenesis, since all or part of axoneme of the sperm tail is formed in the cytoplasm or get exposed to the cytoplasm.
Please subscribe and thanks for watching.